coach? No. But the type of coach he has, the head coach, I think he's going to get him down just like, oh, man, what is my man's name? Did with Cutler this year. He just went over there, was it?
Gase?
Yeah, how Gase had
Cutler.
He had him patient and playing well. So I think the same thing there.
Better line around Cutler.
I mean, that's true.
You know what, Cutler, I'm not a Cutler fan, and Cutler actually did damn good last year.
He showed a lot of discipline.
Well, but now we got another offensive coordinator.
But they're from the same family, though.
It's still not the same person.
It's not the same, but they got the same philosophy. You got the head coach, so they got the same philosophy.
What your Bears going to do? What the Bears gonna do? Minnesota clown in the steel, and you still got Green Bay over Detroit. We all know Detroit ain't on shit.
Damn,
man. Detroit ain't on shit, man. You know nothing.
The Bears, I think the Bears are next playoff.
Ooh.
I think the Bears have made it for one, now you have that burden of Forte gone. You get what I'm saying? Can he do this? Can he do that? Now you're building your team philosophy around Fox. Now you got, what's it, Carey in the backfield, and what's the other dude from Michigan State, the one that I like? I'm having a brain freeze right now. Jeremy Langford. You know, you got them two in the backfield right now, which is basically Forte and two, because Langford is learning how to catch up the backfield much better. You know, running with the ball here, Mom. One thing I didn't like about Forte, it was like one hit and go down. It's like, dude, where's your other football moves at the contract? You get what I'm saying? That's what Forte had, no power. Now, I saw Forte one day in the casino, right? And you know, like when you see players, you like, you know, you poke your chest out, look at, see how I match up with these motherfuckers. You know what I'm saying? And I saw him, and I looked at his legs. You know what I'm saying? Because with athletes, you know, I ain't got to say no homo because I'm secure in my sexuality. But I looked at his legs because, you know, with these athletes, you know, you want to see how big they live. This dude has some small legs. And I'm looking like, no wonder you can't push no line or nothing, man. You ain't got no power. Your legs ain't nothing. But up top, he was swole. You know what I'm saying? So it's like he had no lower body strength. And I looked, I say, that's why you no good in the goal line.
Hey,
you
but,
have no power, man.
Hey, but you got to remember, though, Forte said cut on a whole lot of shit last year, man.
Yeah, he did.
Forte said dumb screens was a, and that's going to be a big miss. You know what I'm saying? You know, of course I'm a Raider fan, die hard, but I live in Chicago, so I study, I watch the Bears just like y'all Bear fans do. You know what I'm saying? When it's 10 o'clock and it's what was Fox Sunday Live, whatever, whoever's on the Fox 32, I tune in, so I watch them. You know what I'm saying? But and I noticed that Forte, man, he say color on a lot of fucking plays. And now that he's gone, I don't know, man. It's gonna be rough.
We're gonna miss that emergency net, because that's what he was for
pretty much. Yeah. One year when he lead, didn't he lead the league in not the league, but didn't he lead the team in receiving yards or something like that?
Receiving yards and catching. It was every year was like that. But Langford getting better, him making games. You know, that if you even go back to the whole Derrick Rose thing, it's about a bit. You know, we stuck with Forte, but we didn't grow that much with him. You know, once Lovey was gone, it was like, okay, damn. Now that whole identity gone, then what happened with that organization? They start cleaning house. I think Forte was the last one of the Lovey era, right?
Yeah.
That was the last one? Cutler the last
Cutler, one. Cutler the last one.
What's Cutler?
Yeah, Cutler, yeah.
Yeah, Cutler the last one?
Yeah, Cutler was the last one.
The last one of the other, you know?
I'm trying to think who else is still over there. That's hard. I'm trying to think. Maybe somebody over there still. Yeah, so Robbie Gould's still there.
And he might not even be there after this year. Uh-huh. He might not even be there at the start of the year. I read a while that he was having a little, you know, little spat with them and everything else with the organization. So it's like a lot of things playing to play, and it goes back to what we were talking about with Fred Hoiberg and the whole organization thing. When a new coach come in, one thing we got to do as fans, we got to expect a whole big-ass overhaul and change. And that's what I was trying to, like, talk to a lot of Bulls fans about when it came to the whole Derrick Rose situation. I'm a big-ass Derrick Rose fan. Am I hurt by that? I'm very hurt by that, because I think he should have finished it. You get what I'm saying? But at the same time, you do got to understand the business that he do have bad wheels. You get what I'm saying? I do blame the staff. Because what are you getting paid for? The dude constantly getting hurt, but that's a whole other story. He did. He is getting hurt. You out throwing this dude money and he's not playing. So let's think about this from the owner aspect right now, and let's stop looking at it from the fan aspect. I think Derrick Rose's move was very much so a business move instead of a personal move. Jerry Reinsdorf actually loved Derrick Rose. He even said it out of his mouth himself in interviews that I didn't saw. But you got to look with his brothers saying this and his brothers saying that, and they all in his ear, and you got the people of Chicago all in your ear. You got to, I think Rose, in a way, after I slept on it, I think the best thing for him right now in his career was to go to New York. I'm not even going to lie to you. When I seriously think about it, his best thing was to go to New York right now. Because us Chicago fans, us as a city, we were actually tearing them down. To be honest. Nobody was giving them a chance. You don't think so? It's what?
I gave him a chance. No, man, I was riding with a man. When he had that MCL, I'm like, damn, man. I hope he come back and bounces back. What started getting me was, like I say, sitting out games talking about his hamstring and certain shit like that. I've never heard other players do that.
Only you know your body. That's my thing. You can't compare yourself. You can't compare him to other players because when you wipe your ass, you don't want to wipe your ass. And if you wipe your ass too hard, you don't want to know you wiped your ass too hard, right?
I mean, I understand. I understand what you're saying, but give me other players who've done that. If you do that, then I'll shut up.
What's naming other players that done it is going to do about him knowing his body and be getting out there 100% and performing at the level that we need him to perform? My thing is, okay, I hate this analogy of paying humans to machines, but if you got a car outside, right, and you know it takes four full-flated tires to run that car evenly and smooth, right? Outside of the engine and everything else. So if one of those tires are flat, you going to keep driving that car? No, you going to fix it, right? And you going to wait and see what the actual problem with that car just in case the tires ain't just in case something is wrong. Actually, ain't wrong with the tires. I'm trying to get my analogy straight. Yo, you throwing me off because you smiling, man.
Nah, you know, you know what? Nah, I think.
You get what I'm saying, though, man. No. He knows his body, Joe. That's basically what I'm saying. You going to the doctor, right? You going to the doctor because you don't feel good. You get an opinion about that, right? Okay, then. At the same time, that doctor going to give you medicine. If you continue having that problem, you're going to go right back to that doctor, right? And you probably going to prescribe you something else, right? Just to get that problem worked out, right? And then you're going to go back if that problem keep having because that's what it's for, right?
Yeah.
Okay, then. But you know your body. You know your medicine. You know this medicine not responding to your body correctly, right? Why do you keep going back to that doctor? So if you constantly giving me this medicine and I'm stepping out on this court and I'm constantly getting hurt, why am I going to this doctor? Why am I still stepping on this court? Because this doctor, what he's telling me and what he's doing is not getting me 100%. Your expertise has a flaw in it. And that's basically what I'm trying to say. Before you started to smile and you threw me off. Now, do you understand my analogy now?
So it's the trainers, huh?
I think very much so.
So what you saying that, do you know he had
I think he said fuck the trainers.
Yeah, he had his own trainers.
Yeah, and he went to preserve himself and he took care of himself his way.
Now, I thought it was weird that he went to Northwestern or whatever to get knee surgery. I thought he was going to James Andrews, who actually is in every sport. I watch wrestling. It was a guy who was hamstring off his damn bone. Triple H. He went to James Andrews. Next year, he came back bigger than ever. So I thought it was weird that he got a surgery there and everything in that nature, you know. Maybe it's not what he's doing. It's just how he was saying it, or it didn't look like it was there.
Very poor way. Expressing himself. He has a very fucking poor way of expressing himself. And he has that, you know how a kid has brutal honesty because they don't know how to express themselves and like cover it up and sugarcoat it. It's like, well, I'm just going to look away and say it and whatever happens. He has that type of like response, like, I don't know really what to say, but if it sound right, you know, I know it's the truth of myself, so I'm just going to say it. he needs better PR, man. Like, you got his brothers around him, and I'm not blaming his brothers for nothing. You got his brothers around him, but I'm going to be honest with you. I don't think he has good business-minded people around him.
Most definitely, because where these niggas come? They ain't come from Northwestern Business School. These motherfuckers from 61st and 2nd Mile or some shit. You know what I'm saying?
So
they come in there and tell, yeah, we his managers. You know, managing so, what?
You know, so I think a lot of Derrick Rose turmoil in Chicago came with a lot of, I think if they would have just let that dude play ball, and just, I think he should have pulled a Marshawn Lynch. I'm just here so I don't get fined. I truly think
Derrick was a little timid and nervous, man, out there playing. I think that injury of first tearing his ACL, which in my opinion he had no business being out there in the first place. I do blame Thibodeau on that, and the way we was up by 15, wasn't it? With like a minute, 2 minutes left. He had no business being out there. Okay, that happened, that's past, whatever. But
you know,
I think
that's not a secure game, man.
Yeah, right. You know, he always down to the last minute, last second. But I think truly, like, and then he messed his other knee up when he was in Portland. And so I think that the same year, I think it was a mind thing with him. It was like
20-some games in.
Yeah, I think he was nervous. Like, damn, you know, it's like,
and that's what people need
because
to
understand. because he was known. That was his game. He was going to the hole. Exactly. But you know what I think though. And I wish somebody would have talked to him and probably talked to him like, yo, Rose, you can't be going to the lane like that, dunking like that. You really can't be. Because if you think about it, Isaiah Thomas would do that a whole lot. If you look at Isaiah Thomas' rookie year, Isaiah Thomas used to dunk on people, Joe. Seriously. Go look at go. I'm telling you. He used to be dunking on cats, Joe. And Iverson was another one. Yeah. And they told him, look, you got to preserve your knees, bro. It's cool to you want to get up there and dunk, but you got to preserve your shit. But Rose, he was dunking like he was 6'8", bro.
Let me say this.
A monster.
And you bring up Iverson. And I think that's where a lot of problems come in at with Rose, too. And I'm not defending Rose. I'm just defending, like, all the sports talk, period. When you mention Rose, it always comes to mind. Iverson. It always comes to mind. Iverson. You know what I'm saying? So you put him on that plateau because those people at that height and that size, they dominated the game. I mean, they used to go down there amongst the trees and dominate the game. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah, for sure.
And so it's like, it's all when you build the road, you put them in that same mindset. But you got to understand, like, those are all different caliber of players. You know what I'm saying? Iverson was an instant leader, man. He was an instant leader. Rose lack a little bit on the leadership, man, and that comes with his whole vocal and his whole mentality. Is he that one we want to get around behind and give us that spirit and get behind? Yeah, but can he lead our Bulls team? No, he's too quiet, man. He's too passive, and I think he listens to other people too much. That's why I say I think this might be the best thing for him, because now you don't have the city over you no more. You don't have that umbrella. Now we can't stop the rain.
He's not the guy per se of the team.
Now we can't stop the rain, so whatever you do, it's on you, man. I think this is a growing up process, man. I'm going to be honest with you.
I wish him well though. I wish him well to the fullest. Well. I know when I get NBA 2K17, I'm gonna play with the Knicks.
I'm gonna definitely play with the Knicks. I'm already a fellow fan. I ain't gonna lie to you. If they get no over there, I'm really gonna play. But it's still C Red all day, man. I'm a Bulls fan to the end, man. Like, you know, it's just that at times, man, I don't understand what they're doing. But I try to understand it, but I also look at the brighter side of things. I just don't look at it from one way. Would he get MVP? Would he get to MVP form? Nah, it ain't enough ball for him, Mello, man. I mean, I'm a fan of both of them, man.
No, I'm looking at what Stephen A. Smith said. That, like, man, was it an upgrade? Yeah. We'll get a championship? Hell no. So, that's what I'm thinking of when you said that. On the perspective of this, I know that we've been dogging Foreman and Paxson, but they was the ones who dug out that baby Bulls. We remember them.
Yeah.
I mean, they couldn't have did nothing wrong. I mean, couldn't always did nothing wrong. They had Kurt Heinrich, They drafted Lou Alden. Yeah, Ben Gordon.